Sundarraman, for that wonderful insight on the various patients that you have and how we can live to our 100th birthday. One thing that I am now fearing is what my doctor would be speaking about me to his other Toastmaster clubs. but all in good humor. Thanks a lot for that very insightful speech. And our next speaker for the day, before I introduce him, I'd like to call upon his evaluator, very senior Mr. Thomas. Read out his objectives, please.
The next speech has this purpose. The purpose of this project is for the member to learn or review basic research methods and present a well-organized, well-researched speech on any topic. Over to you.
Thank you. Now, Toastmaster Sundarraman was the first person I ever contacted at many Toastmasters Club. He was the DTM Sundarraman, the first person I ever contacted. He was the VP membership at the time. And it is because of him I joined the club, and he's a big reason why I'm in the club. But he has a very special skill. You know, footballers, there are these few very star skilled footballers that stand out from the rest. And this one special skill, any guesses?
Dribbling.
Sorry?
Dribbling?
Dribbling, no. DTM Sundarraman.
Dribbling.
Okay. No? Not in football, but in life and in Toastmasters. Cooking? Possibly. That might be an answer because a lot of
he
us...
He can convince his wife to join Toastmasters.
Exactly. A big round of applause. Very few married Toastmasters managed to do, but Toastmasters Sundarraman is definitely someone who has the special skill set, the unique skill
set. Not only his wife, but also his son.
His son as well. Okay. So the entire family. This is definitely something that needs to be given a big round of applause. Please welcome to pitch here to deliver his top speech title, Hydroponics and Aeroponics, DTM Sundarraman.
Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters and guests. I used to be calling myself as a jack of all trades and master of none. The reason is I was having a lot of hobbies. Gardening was one of my hobbies. In my younger days, I was so fascinated about gardening. What does it mean? Actually, I used to water the plants. That's all, nothing more. But unfortunately, I could not continue when I moved to Chennai because Chennai is a classic example for being a concrete jungle. In fact, in our apartment, I had a very small space. So once in a while, whenever I, during my birthday event, I used to plant a tree. And again, after that, I forget it. But if we want to pursue gardening, and if you have to understand the basics. So what are all the fundamental elements that are required for a plant to grow? I think all of us might have studied in our classrooms, class days, school days. What are all the fundamental things that are needed?
Water,
sunlight,
soil, water, right? I think all of us agree with this, right? But there is a small bit here. Water is essential for any plant to grow. Sunlight is essential for a plant to grow. But the soil, not directly per se. The nutrients in the soil that are essential. Even without soil, a plant can be grown. So the kind of nutrients that are present in the soil, that helps the plant to grow. What are the nutrients?
Nitrogen.
So we have the nutrients, they are classified as primary nutrients, something like nitrogen. Sometimes it is in the form of ammonia or ammonia-based fertilizers. Or the secondary nutrients like potassium and sodium. Then we have the micronutrients like cadmium, magnesium, sulfur, etc., etc. So these are the essential things that are vital for a plant to grow or a tree or any orchard that requires. So in that context, if we understand this basic fundamental, is it possible to cultivate plants without soil? Without soil, can we do that?
No.
Yes. But do we have such kind of technology without soil growing a plant? And if at all, if there is a technology or if at all there is a method, so what is your guess? When you would have identified
some
such techniques.
Will come in water.
Yes. Yes.
Not in soil. Ceramics.
You are right.
So what happens?
So there is a concept called soilless cultivation or soilless farming, and this concept is nothing new. So this has been discussed and researched way back in 1627. There are literature evidences say that people have discussed and researched, and people believe. So whatever I said in the introduction, so it is the requirement of the nutrients and not the soil as it is required for a plant to grow. So in the absence of soil, still plant can grow if we are able to provide sunlight, water, and these basic nutrients. So today, a lot of research have gone, and today commercially it is viable to cultivate the plants, and you can have a large-scale farming without soil. The soilless farming is classified into two major categories. The first one is called hydroponics. The practice of planting, the practice of growing plants in nutrient-enriched water without soil. The second one is, even it need not be planted in a pot or something like that, it can still hang in the air. So the roots are exposed. So if you see this picture, I think a lot of malls or hotels, you might have seen such kind of facility on the compound wall, right? You see plastic PVC pipes in which the plants are potted and water supply is given. So that is a classic example for hydroponics. So in case of the aeroponics, the root is totally exposed. So there is no need to support the root, the environment in which the plants are grown. So if you spray water which is containing the micronutrients or the major nutrients, automatically the plant can absorb that and it can start growing. And in the last few years, this technique has been widely accepted in several countries. So even the drip irrigation is something similar to that, but countries like Israel, they adopted drip irrigation and they have seen large-scale benefit even without any river, without any good amount of water. With the small consumption of water, they were able to produce massive results. And today, this technology is widely used in countries which has large deserts. And 90% of the farmers claim that the hydroponic crops use 90% less water. See here, today we are struggling for even potable water, and every state is having water issue in our country. Not only in our country, even a lot of other countries, they have the water is a major issue. We are able to save 90% of the water for cultivation, so that will be a awesome job. And you can plant four times the amount of crops in the same space, so that is called optimization. So in the given space, you can plant four times more crops, and two times it will grow faster than conventional means. The plants can grow two times faster than that, and finally there is no need for any pesticide or herbicide. So that is going to be a large advantage, because today all of us have some ailment or other, and primarily the physicians say that the pesticides that are the root cause for most of our ailments. And today this technology has come to India, and in fact a lot of startup entrepreneurs, they adopted this. For example, there is a couple, Sachin and Shweta, they are in Hyderabad, that they are doing this organic farming. So the entire farming is happening without applying soil. So you can see lot of salad leaves. The salad leaves, so they are all cultivated using the hydroponic technique, and they are making huge profit. There is a very big article in the Hindu, and if you Google, then you will come to know about it in detail. And if at all, if you want to continue our hobby of gardening, even in an apartment, so today a lot of people are suggesting to go to a terrace, put a soil, and then start doing gardening. So in fact, in one of my apartments, the apartment started leaking, and people were saying that one particular guy, he has dumped lorry loads of soil on the rooftop. So people are sometimes over-enthusiastic, and it has now affected the strength of the building. So no need to get into such kind of headaches. So you have small cooler stuff which are available online. So in Amazon you can order such kind of technologies like sensors, control valves, mechanisms, timers available. Even in your balcony, if you want to grow plants of your choice, then you can continue your hobby. With that, let me close. Over to Toastmasters.